In this particular video, we are going to study the genetic counseling topic. Let's see the definition first. So this term was coined by Sheldon Reed of Minnesota University in the year 1940. So this is how you start your answer. Then you can give a standard definition like Harper has given here, or you can write a general definition on your own. This standard definition is given by Harper in 1994. He defines the term genetic counseling as the process by which the patients or relatives at the risk of a disorder that may be hereditary are advised of the consequences of the disorder, the probability of developing and transmitting it, and the ways in which this may be prevented or ameliorated. So basically there are four parts here. First, the diagnosis is done of whatever the disease they are having, and it should be hereditary. And then what will be the consequences of that particular disease, and what is the recurrence chance, how much is the probability of transmitting it to new offsprings, and then how to treat it or how to prevent it, and what will be the exact risk in which it will be transmitted. So whether to have children or not children, all these things are coming under genetic counseling. As the name suggests, it's a counseling process. Means basically it's giving all the information, genetic information, to the people who need it, who have that particular disease in their family, and they want to get rid of that particular disease somehow. So you can just mug up this definition, or you can write by your own wording, it does not matter. Then some of the points which you should know about genetic counseling, which are very, very important. The first point means there is a difference between eugenics. We have just studied eugenics in the previous video. And what are the rules applicable to genetic family counseling? So these six rules are very, very important. And how? So first rule is that advisor should be value neutral and should not force his own value on those who seek advice. So you know that in eugenics, basically eugenics is not value neutral. It is value loaded, where some people are propagating, or means they are pleading for certain traits which are desirable and certain traits which are undesirable, and based on that they advised the procreation process. So this what we studied in eugenics, but in genetic counseling it is always value neutral, and you just have to give the facts. You don't have to impose your value on those who seek advice. So as a consequence of it, the couple should be able to decide on their own regarding the future reproduction. And third, this is very important, that the advice should be based on best and latest information which genetics has to offer. So it should be very, very precise. It should be based on facts. It should be based on research. For example, the chromosomal analysis should be done, or there are different methods in which we do the analysis of our cells, our genes. So all those methods we will study in chapter 9. So those methods should be utilized before giving any advice. Then next point is that genetic diseases are specific and they have a specific mode of inheritance. How the genetic diseases are inherited, that you will study again in chapter 9. There are different modes of inheritance. There are specifically four modes: autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, then sexual genes dominant and sexual genes recessive. All these things we will study in chapter 9. So when those topics will be covered, you will know that. So this is very important point, that all the genetic diseases have very, very specific mode of inheritance. And so this mode of inheritance should be diagnosed and it should be known. Then so therefore every case requires a careful record of proband's pedigree. What is proband? Proband is the main person on whom the study is being done, and means who has that particular trait or disease or that particular gene which is not required. So pedigree means the total analysis of all the ancestors and the next generations of the proband, and writing about their whatever the diseases they were having and all those things. So pedigree analysis you will also study in chapter 9. So where all the members, normal or otherwise, of the family must be recorded in that particular pedigree analysis of proband, and a careful analysis done for each member. So medical and family history is very, very important in genetic counseling. The next point is that this is very important, that some genetic diseases and some phenotypically similar clinical conditions, means they have something similar. So means some clinical normal disease should not be equated to a genetic disease. So genetic disease are inherited by a specific mode, they are inherited by genetically. So it should be made certain that it is a genetic disease, not a normal disease. So means the differentiation should be exact. And the next point is that all factual information should be provided to counseled couple. Same thing as we just told here, that it should be value neutral and couple should be able to decide on their own. It should be based on best research and latest information and all those things. So all the factual information should be given to the couples. And after giving the facts, the risks and the degree of that means of that particular disease, it should also be told. And the final decision should be left on those getting counseled. So exact diagnosis is needed, research records giving the empirical risk figure should also be taken into consideration, all those things. So means basically you can shorten it and write in your own wordings, all these things. All these things which are highlighted or which are used in capital letters, they are the keywords like probands, pedigree, specific mode of inheritance, genetic disease, and a phenotypically similar clinical condition. Here exact diagnosis, value neutral, so genetic counseling, all these things you have to mug up and use in your own answers. So I will give a link in the description below, a question on genetic counseling which you can attempt. Thank you so much, and let's study some other topic in next video.